Good morning, everybody. It is Thursday. I have literally just opened my eyes.
Want to go outside? Go on then.
I feel like Nala's forgotten what wintry weather is like and she just refuses to go on the grass. Look at her. All right. Fussy. She hates getting her feet wet. Oh, okay. There we won't look anymore. I personally cannot wait for August. We're in August, sorry, autumn. I can't wait for autumn and I can't wait for winter. It's gonna be amazing. This feels quite wintry this morning. It's making me quite excited for like hot porridge and just cozy days. We actually haven't been able to light any of the fires that we have. Well, apart from one which is underneath the TV, because that room actually can get quite chilly in the evenings. Ta-da!
Sam and Adam bought me this, my hairdressers. Cute, isn't it?
I say me. It's for me and Alfie. Finished? But all the other fires around the house, like log burners, we've not lit those yet because it's just been so hot. We also haven't turned on the Argy yet because it's been really hot, but those are all things I'm very excited to do. Done, and I can't talk, and now I'm up in my office, but it's really dark. Ta-da! Can't let you see what's on the floor. I really need to move it. Oh, now that I am ready for the day, I need to start putting the footage that I filmed of me and Mark on my laptop because I'm going to start editing it. I haven't even filmed my video for this week, which I'm doing tomorrow. This is for a couple of weeks' time, but I feel like I should put it on my laptop anyway because if I leave things too long, sometimes I lose the memory card or I misplace it or I forget and then I end up losing the footage, which is not good. This room could definitely do with some fairy lights. I'm thinking like up there on that, just like a string of fairy lights all the way along and maybe some along, where's my finger, along there as well, because this room is probably one of the darker rooms in the house, I want to say, and it's generally the one that I spend most of the daytime in during the week, so I feel like we could put some fairy lights up in here and make it a little bit more cozy. I am now going to import this footage. And then I have a call with my therapist on Skype. And then my friend Jay is coming, which I'm so excited about. Hello! With Jay.
Hi.
Oh my god, do you know what we should do?
What?
The last time I filmed a clip like this with both of us in it. Oh my god, was that the last time I ever filmed you?
I don't know what you're talking about. So
the time in the car when we were eating McDonald's.
I think so. I think it was.
Oh my god. Okay, so
we did a video.
For any of you who have been watching my videos for a really long time, like I'm talking like a really long time. Okay, fine. When did we put that up? 2001?
No!
No! I was 11 then!
That would make me like 9.
2011?
Probably, yeah.
It was about 2011, and if there's any of you watching this that have seen that video, you are a real, like, true Zoella OG. Because that was a really long time ago, and me and Jay were sat in Jay's car before I was about to get on a train to London, eating McDonald's, just chatting.
I guess it wasn't like a story time thing, but it was just talking.
It was just like me and Jay randomly. I might insert a little clip.
Oh no.
I might insert a little clip.
Flashback.
Now.
Unless we're sat here just talking with our mouths full, this is gonna be like the most repulsive video.
Do you not think my voice is overly low?
No.
Really?
Do you think mine's high?
just opposite the Evian Mountains, they're on the bottle. Yeah, how's that for a bit of name dropping?
What did you say? Do they suit me?
I don't know. No.
Oh.
Bye! What's that?
How much did you love that? That video I actually still have on my channel, but it's private. Because everyone was hating on us because we were talking and eating. Also, I think back then people only wanted to see me do hauls and like beauty videos, and they did not like that I would just uploaded a video of like me and Jay sat in a car talking about random stuff.
Talking about
whilst eating. Yeah. Also, it was quite crude. Like, the video is quite crude. Like, I don't think I could put
it was very much public again. I think how we are together.
Yeah, quite crude. Anyway, Jay, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. I'm very good.
I just asked Jay to put this bracelet on me. And what is it that you said? I can't do it because I've just had a manicure
and I've had my nails cut, so I couldn't do the clasp.
He's like, oh, I've just had my nails done and I can't. I'm like, you have better nails than me right now.
Man problems.
I don't know anywhere around here that does nails, actually. Yeah. That's good. I need to find like a little hidden gem for nails.
We could get, surely there's a lady that, like a mobile lady, that would come and do it.
I would love that, but I don't know. If any of you know anyone in the Brighton area that does mobile nails, can you please let me know on Twitter? Because I would like to have someone to come and do my nails. That would be great. And my toenails. They're holographic.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, they're holographic.
Oh. Your feet are so tiny.
Alfie says that to me every time I don't wear shoes. It's like, why are your feet?
I don't know.
There's only one way to find out.
They are.
Are they actually?
Well,
wait. Yeah, nearly.
Oh my god. I can't believe you're such a true friend. You're actually touching the bottom of my feet. Oh, I need to show you this. So my bracelet that I was asking Jay to put on me was from Ellie Goulding, which was so nice of her. She sent me this from Daisy London. I'm just like filming my chest. I'll turn this round. From Daisy London, and it says, Zoe, thanks so much for your support. By wearing this bracelet, you will help in the crucial fight against climate change. Together we can make a difference. Love, Ellie. Also a very beautiful picture of her in there. But it's so cute. Look, it's a little polar bear. It's so cute. So thank you so much.
Little hairs on
them. All right. I just said to Jay, my legs are so hairy. He's like stroking them. He's like, they feel like my tomato plant that I'm growing. And then he's like, actually, it feels like a courgette.
At least it's not green and patchy.
Well, I don't know. Sometimes I do think my legs look a bit like green. Look at that.
Is that like, is that it?
I don't know what that is.
Very yellow.
I think it's like fly poo.
Excuse
or something.
Me?
I have washed, it won't come off.
Since when is fly poo a thing?
Since we lived here, flies poo on you in the garden.
But why is it that big? It's like bigger than a fly.
Yeah, maybe that's not fly poo. I don't know what that is. I just offered Jay a cheese straw. He's like, no, I'm gluten free. I swear I forget every time.
It's fine, don't worry.
And I was like, oh, porridge for breakfast. He's like,
it's funny the amount of things that, like, people don't understand wheat is or isn't in. Someone the other day said, is there wheat and cheese? And I was like, no.
No, but there is dairy and cheese. You can have dairy, can't you?
Yeah. Michael can't have dairy.
Oh god, so the two of you in your cupboard is just like
everything I cook at home non-dairy. Is dairy free.
Wow.
Yes.
That's probably why you're so healthy. Then you come here and I'm like, want a cheese straw? Cheese straw is something that both you and Michael can't eat.
I know, yeah.
We're in the car, heading to lunch. There's Alphonse and Jayfonse. I'm so hungry.
Me too.
I was about to have a coffee before we left, and I was like, no, they do such good coffee there. Wait,
oh, do they?
Like,
yeah.
Oh, right.
I'm saying, yeah, like, I drink. No, I have had a...
You had a sip of the coffee before?
Yeah, I did.
And you did
I'm
like
gonna
it.
Get a chai latte.
Oh, that's...
I have chai lattes now, Jay. I never had
chai. You sound so grown up.
She's bloody crazy now.
I am
since
a changed
came a month
woman.
Ago to the house, she's just a different person.
It's really interesting how much chais vary.
considering like coffee's either good or bad, whereas like Starbucks's chai is really sweet and what is it, Nero's chai is super spicy.
Oh really? I haven't tried Nero.
Oh really?
But I do like the Starbucks one, so yeah, maybe Starbucks I'm more of like
really
a
really tasty.
Also I really like the one they do at Flowerpot Bakery, which is a little bakery in Brighton. Theirs is really good. It's like Christmassy though. I feel like it's quite like an autumny wintery drink.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Is always my favourite section. Look at that Neapolitan cake. Oh my god. I'm gonna have to have a piece of that. Oh, passion fruit and white chocolate. Oh my god, there's too much choice. Chai latte. What did you get?
Regular latte.
Oh, regular.
Fully caffeinated.
Non-Christmassy. What have you gone for, Al?
All year round.
A latte, but single shot.
Oh, are they normally double then?
I haven't eaten yet. I know I'll be shaking. I don't know. Some places do double.
Yeah.
So is yours the double?
The other day and I was shaking afterwards and said, was it single or double what I just drank? She was like, don't worry, it was double. And I was like,
that could be wild. Felt something in my shoe. It was this. Like, look at the size of this.
What are you doing?
Oh, what are you putting on the table?
I just wanted to show you it.
Wait, that is hairy.
How did that even land in my shoe? It was like crawling down that back bit of my foot. Oh, reaction of this cake, because it is so good.
Is that
good.
Bad if I all in one that?
You can do it. I know you can
do
it.
I know I can, but is it bad?
No. I wonder what that feels like. Feels like, tastes like, to have all the flavours at once. Because that's like, no, I can't fit that in all in my mouth. It's good, isn't it?
That's the only way to pop an experience.
Oh my god. Yeah. Finished lunch, now we're just going for a little stroll up the town.
Is that what it says?
What did it say?
I really love you.
Aww. Oh, I forgot that this hill was quite so steep. Slinkies. Feels even steeper after you've had lunch.
Who doesn't want a slinky? Look at the earring holders.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. I mean, pretty topical.
That's great.
Did you like your lunch?
My lunch was really good, really tasty.
Did you like your lunch?
Yeah, I love that spot.
Good.
What size is it though? I know it's supposed to be oversized, but
is
there not a slightly smaller
one?
But didn't you have it on inside out,
darling?
Do you
know?
No.
No,
you don't, but there's like a weird...
It's got like a weird line.
We're heading back now. We just went into a little shop called From Victoria Shop and Studio, which is in Needlemaker's Studio Yard. What was it called? Needlemakers.
I think it's just called the Needlemakers.
Just the Needlemakers. So if you're ever in Lewis, go into that shop because it's like plant heaven. Yeah, so there's lots of other little shops in there and there's also a little cafe, but the shop From Victoria just has like the best selection of like beautifully illustrated cards and house plants.
Wrapping paper.
And like wrapping paper. I basically just went card crazy. People always need cards, so you may as well stock up if you see some nice ones. And I also bought a plant. Let me see if I can show you. Look! It's so cute. She said that the little needles tend to drop off quite a lot, but when they do, you just have to pick them up and pop them back in, like into the middle, and then they'll regrow, which I thought was kind of cool. I've never owned one of these before, so hopefully it's fairly like low maintenance, but we shall soon find out. My future, forget my past. If you wanna get with me, better make it fast. This was Jay's request, a bit of Spice Girls.
Throwback.
And it's a Thursday.
Guys, if you know about the basil, then you know, but it's finally had it. My trusty basil that I took from the old house just gave up in the end. I bought a new one already, but I thought I'd better vlog and say goodbye to this one because it did us really well for such a long time. Let's all just take a moment. Oh, I should put it in the compost actually, shouldn't I? Okay, let's get rid of the plastic pot and I'm gonna go and put this in the compost. I also have the rosemary that has seen better days also. Okay, farewell my basil. You served me well for so long. I'm sorry I couldn't keep you alive in the end. I think the heat of the kitchen eventually took its toll. But, I mean, I feel like I did a very good job of keeping it alive on those exceptionally hot days at the start of summer, but I think it just killed off, like the leaves were never the same, like they kept growing out yellow and I was like, I'm just not sure about this anymore. So yeah, bye basil. So I thought it would be nice, since Jay's here, and we haven't really like sat down and done like a proper video in a really long time. Not that that original video was a proper video. but because Jay is like a friend of mine before YouTube, I haven't really ever done like a Q&A with an OG friend. Do you know what I mean? Like a pre-Zoella friend. Actually, you met me when I was doing YouTube.
Yeah.
But it was like early days of YouTube. So I went on Twitter and I asked you guys, this is very rocky, I asked you guys if you had any questions. Do you ever wonder how, like, this is my job? Like, look at me right now. I'm like balancing this on a freaking candle. That's my first question to you. Do you feel like I'm good at what I do? Oh my God, the delay!
No, I'm trying to think about a longer answer than yes. Because it's like anything, when I started my job, I had someone there that trained me and taught me how to do things and kind of showed me the way. And because you're like one of the first people to have it in such a
severe way,
that I have a lot of admiration for the fact that you wouldn't have had anyone to go to being like, oh, this happened and I don't know how to act because no one else has done it. So I would say I think you're very good at what you do and I have a lot of admiration for what you do.
See,
good reason for delay, I think.
Yeah, that was a great delay. I feel like the first question to answer would be, how did we meet and when did we meet?
I don't know when. I can't
There must
remember.
Be a way of working it out.
Oh, wait,
go
wait,
on
wait.
Your Facebook, Facebook and see when friendship. We became friends. You know it. We met in New Look. So we both worked in New Look in our little town, which neither of us live there anymore.
No, no. January 2011.
Whoa, so 2011, and we would have kind of been friends before this because no one ever goes, hey, nice to meet you, what's your Facebook? You were in sixth form.
Yeah, I was still at school.
And I was... Oh my God, can you send that to me so I can put it in this video? I'm gonna insert the picture that Jay just showed me. It is crazy. I feel like we just instantly became friends.
Yeah, I think it was kind of, we were forced together in the sense of working together. And you used to work in the fitting room.
Yeah, I was in the fitting room.
And I wasn't allowed to work in the fitting room because it was a girl's shop. But I used to come in and take the clothes to be put back out that people didn't buy.
And we used to stand and there was like this one, I feel like our old bosses might watch this and be like, you are terrible. So there used to be like this little blind spot. Do you remember it?
Well, there was no cameras in the thing anyway.
There was no cameras in the fitting room.
No.
But if you lingered, so the people doing the taking the clothes out and taking them back out to the store, if you lingered, clear rail. Oh my God, that's what it was called.
Yeah, you're on clear rail.
And it was CR in the little thing.
Uh-huh, in the rotor, yeah.
Oh my God. And if you lingered in there, they would come in and tell you off and tell you to get out.
But there what are you doing? You're chatting. Come on.
Yeah, stop chatting. But there was this one little bit where you could come in and if you just go a little bit to the left, we could stand and chat by that rail because they couldn't walk past and like see in. So that's where we used to chat.
So I've got a question that I screenshotted, which is what's the one thing that always manages to come up in conversation?
What that me and you have?
I don't know.
Food?
Food, yeah. I think maybe like old times. We always seem to talk about the people we used to know that we worked with there as well because neither of us are really friends with. Like, in the way that we're friends, we're not really friends with anyone else that we worked with. So kind of talking about the people like, we used to work with.
What are they doing now? And I feel like we have a good balance of talking about old times, but also we always talk about like current and like future stuff.
Things that are going to be happening and for me going away and for you things you're doing.
Yeah. Someone's put, this is for Jay. I wanted to ask you, how do you feel about what Zoe does for a living? Did you get it at first or did it take some time?
Well, when we first met, it wasn't really as big of a thing.
And also, I didn't feel like I needed to like tell him what I was doing, because what I was doing was working in New Look. Like, back then, YouTube wasn't my job. In fact, do you remember a conversation that I had with you once when we left New Look? And it was about whether I should do it full time.
Yeah.
Because I'd worked out in my head how much I could make if I just carried on blogging and doing the videos.
Yeah.
And I remember telling you, and there were some other people around, and they were, I don't think they were as keen, but you were like...
Yeah, I think because it wasn't really, I don't know, I never would have suffered a judgment on what anyone did. So for you to just be like, oh, I blog on the side and I make videos, I just thought was cool because it's not something I'd come across before. And now for what it's turned into, I think it's just, I don't know, I think it's... But it's always, it's what she's always done, so it's not so, even though the size of it has grown, it's what you've always done, so I don't see it as strange. It's not like I'm seeing a friend and for the first time ever they're videoing while I'm around or talking about the YouTube based stuff. It's kind of always been the case.
Yeah, that's so true.
So I don't know what the answer to that is. Is kind of, I don't really think anything of it in the nicest way possible.
Yeah, also I think it's good that you don't think about it in that way, because it's what I do, it's not who I am, if that makes sense.
Oh, completely. I would assume some people kind of find it odd if we're out and people stop Zoe. I just kind of, like it happened today, I just carried on looking around the shop while you guys went out and took a photo, and because that's not who she is to me, but I'm fine with it being who she is to someone else. She, Zoe, the person that's next to me. I've had it in the same way that when I've met people that are YouTubers through you, and I've kind of, I haven't been starstruck or anything, but found it like odd being like,
I already know
who this person is, and they're like introducing themselves to me. So, yeah, I don't know. I think it's a mixture of things.
What parts of what I do, this is now like my question, I'm just taking it upon myself. What parts of what I do you think that would be cool? And what other parts of what I do you think I could never deal with that, or I could never cope with that?
I think the variety of things you get to do. Like now, obviously there was a point where you just made videos, even though we were on different subjects, it was a very kind of linear thing. I think the variety of what you get to do, so what I do is I have a kind of what would be an office job, so I do
8 to 4. You have like structure and you know.
Yeah, I go to work every day in the same place, sit at my desk all day. Yeah. I love what I do, don't get me wrong, but I think that the variety might be quite nice. But I think the... I think being able to understand what people find interesting is probably really hard. Like the amount of things that when, you know, like I take photographs or places I go traveling and people are like, what made you do that? And I kind of go, I can't explain why I did it. I just thought it was a nice picture I'm interested to go. So trying to understand content and knowing what people want to see when it's such a normal thing to you, I think would be quite hard. I think it's just quite a lot of pressure as well. Like I kind of go to my job, I go home,
And then you don't really...
Yeah, I think I have become appreciative of my quiet life. Not quiet, because I do like some amazing things, but I don't know, my private life.
Yeah, you don't really have that if you do what I do. Like, but, someone said to me once, like, is there anything people don't know about you? And I was like, no.
I mean, it's parts of your, like, you know, parts of your, like, things that have happened to you before you started doing this that you, there's no reason you would have gone into.
Yeah, exactly.
But I don't think apart from that there would be.
Like, I'm very open. It's probably one of my downfalls, but also one of my, like, what's it called? When it's like your weakness and your strength, like, being a very open person. Was there ever a moment in your friendship where you thought you would fall out?
Oh, God, no, not at all.
No. I think hell no. Like, I have never felt like that.
I think we're just two very laid-back people. I mean, in parts of my life, I'm very uptight about certain things, but I think when it comes to friendship and the kind of friendship we have, because there's been periods, there was a period at one time... Time?
There was a period this one time.
Where we didn't see each other for about 2 years because I emigrated and moved away, I mean, moved out of the UK, and it was when you first moved to Brighton and your stuff really started to kick off. So there was like a 2-year period, but it always feels very... I don't know. It's kind of very like pick up where changes. We left off.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know. I feel like with some friendships, the silence is a bit unnerving and you sort of start thinking, have I done something wrong? Do you think that they, I don't know, do you know what I mean? Like, but I feel like with you, I never feel like that.
Well, that's nice, I'm glad. I think it's kind of like a real mutual understanding of life happens, we're both busy,
yeah,
that's that. And I think a lot of people get pent up being like, they haven't texted me back and we haven't seen each other this long, or they've cancelled, or but I think it's kind of maturity and grown up aspect, yeah, of kind of like, oh, she's really busy, you're I'm away, or I'm busy at home or whatever, and it's just kind of when it happens, it happens. And I think there's no expectation.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember what the question was.
Me neither. Oh, it's kind of this, what we just answered, but it's, this person said, how did your friendship begin and how have you kept it alive all this time? In a nutshell, what's the secret to a healthy and long friendship? I think what you just said, like no expectation and just being like chilled.
If it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't. And there's always the intention there. I mean, obviously, if you have that friend, and this kind of is a classic growing up thing of like, you learn about the people that are bringing things to your life as a friend and you're making more effort with. And I think that if they're not, they're not, and then you just move on. But if they are,
yeah, my mum always says some friends are for a season, mm-hmm, some friends are for a reason, and some friends are for a life, for a life, for a lifetime. There's a fly on my phone.
What would you do if you were Jay for a day and the other way around?
If I was you, I would 100% travel somewhere and not have to worry about it at all. Like, I
so
love
being
talking
me would
to
give
Jay,
you the freedom to
just to go wherever I wanted and not have, yeah, any like negative thoughts about,
yeah,
it. Like, I love speaking to Jay about travel because he finds it so easy to do. It's like going to a coffee shop and buying a coffee for you. It's literally that chilled out, and I just like, I'm so like in awe of that. I'm like, oh, if only I could feel like that, to just be like, that's just, it's like
getting on a plane.
It's like having a shower, getting on a plane. It's like no, yeah, big deal. Like, I would definitely do that if I was you for the day.
I don't know. I think I'd probably hang out with your friends.
My YouTube friends, like my...
Not which, explicitly which your kind? YouTube friends, but I think because you have this real understanding of everyone being in the same boat with most of your friends,
mm-hmm,
and this is going to sound a bit like, wow, ambulance for me, but I don't, where I live in London, I don't have heaps of friends in London, and I think that being surrounded by people that do the same thing as you,
mm-hmm,
have the same, like, you have this kind of unspoken bond on what you do, and I think having those relationships is really nice.
Yeah.
So I think I'd probably hang out with your friends.
Good luck trying to get everyone together for a day, that's
well,
all I'm saying.
Well. Or I'd probably go shopping.
With my bank card.
Yeah. That's like awful. I'm joking.
I'm leaving that in. Is there anything that Jay knows about Zoe which viewers don't?
Absolutely.
Yeah, so many things.
Absolutely.
It looks like I've just changed into Nala.
So Zoe.
Right.
Is that my one? You did you ask?
Someone said, what's the best or funniest memory you have together? One of my favourites is actually last time we hung out, like just me and you, we went into town. We went into a shop.
Oh God, yeah.
We went into a shop and the owner of the shop was talking to some American, like an American family maybe.
Yeah, maybe, I'm not sure.
And they, and the owner was like, oh, you know Zoella, she's a, what was she saying?
She's a vlogger or something like that.
She's a vlogger and she comes in here and this is her favourite, and like was telling them, and me and Jay were in the shop, but the lady didn't spot that we were there.
Yeah.
And I kind of just froze and like squeezed Jay, like I can't handle how awkward this is, because then the other people went, that's why we're here, because we watched Zoella. And I was like, this is either the moment where someone goes, oh, that Zoella's a right twat, or something, or they spot us and then they get really embarrassed, and then in turn we get,
so we
really
kind of had to leave,
so
and
we
I
sort of did a little like
scooch. I touched your arm and I was like, do you want to go? And you were like, yeah. And we kind of like scooched out the shop. We went down the street.
I had like tears streaming down my face. Like, that's never happened before, where someone's been like talking about me because they don't know I'm there, but I can actually hear everything they're saying.
Yeah, no, that's a really good one actually.
What other one? I feel like every time we worked in New Look, something funny happened. What one thing that I ever go to or have been to or been invited to would you want to come with me to? But it can be anything down to like the book printers or like
Oh yeah, I think the creative aspect of it would be really fun. So like I've been there when you've
had a product meeting.
Yeah, so I've been at home with you when you've had like samples of the new range come in, mm-hmm. and I kind of smell them with you, which is a very small part of the process. So I think that would be really interesting to do. I don't think like film premieres or anything like that because I don't.
I've only ever been to two, including Joe.
There was such a concentrated period where it was like the done thing for YouTubers to go to film premieres.
Yeah, I didn't really enjoy premieres. I think that, again, it's just too much. Exactly, this is my point. I just want to get a Tango Ice Blast and sit in the dark.
Tango Ice Blast?
Yeah. I just want to get a Tango Ice Blast, sit in the dark with Alfie, and, like, watch the film, obviously. That could have gone in two ways. There's water been here. Where's it gone?
Well, there's, are these bugs?
There it is.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's a bee.
No, it's a wasp.
Oh.
It'll be fine. Describe each other in one word.
I would say you in one word. Giving.
Oh, that's really nice.
Like, you would give your time to every single person. And, like, you give, like, I don't know, you're just very giving.
That's really sweet.
You're kind. So you feel like kind is like
she's got a great personality.
she's really nice.
I think sincere. I think in the context of what you do, I would say humble. Just being like asking how my work is. Like when we're in the car earlier and being like, oh, how's work? It's such a normal thing, and it's not that I don't expect you to ask me normal things, but when you there are a lot of people that I think wouldn't do that. Mm. That's a really bad friend question.
What?
Which Zoella product do you like the most?
Yeah, Jay, which Zoella product do you like the most?
Honestly, I don't know if I could name one. See, it sounds really bad friend.
No, but it's not because there's so many
but
products.
But I don't do things like that. I don't watch those videos. If there's something that I think is interesting, and like I see a title or a thumbnail, I go, that is genuinely is of interest to me. But it's also because I don't want to turn up and go, so, oh yeah, yesterday looked like you had fun. And then we have nothing to talk about because I know everything that's going on.
What do I do that annoys you?
I don't honestly, and you actually, wait. I wouldn't no, there's nothing that actually annoys me, but sometimes I just kind of go, oh, Zoe.
When I don't reply.
Yes. And I was gonna, the only reason I'm gonna say it is because I've seen you in a video talk about it before.
I'm so bad. But does that not make you feel better that it's not just you?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I've never been like, oh my god, why is she not texting me back? It's just me that she's not replying to.
Rude.
I wouldn't say it even annoys me. I think that's kind of too harsh.
It's one of my bad habits though. I feel like the thing is, every January 1st, I'm like, I'm gonna be so good at replying to people. And then I can never do it. I feel like I keep it up. And then it just slips back. I get texts when I'm like doing my most busy thing of the day, I swear. That was a really loud bird. What was that?
I don't know, but it was probably...
Oh look, it's a woodpecker.
Shut the front door.
So this tree right here, it's like poking its little head round.
I can't see it.
Just wait.
Oh my god.
Do you see it?
Yeah.
I've just realised how many bees are in here.
I think they're not, I don't think they're all bees, I think.
They are?
Oh my god. Why are they in here? That's what I don't understand. There's so much open space out there.
I know. Like, why would you choose to come in here? Like, people go anywhere, guys.
Have you ever had negative comments about being friends with someone of the opposite sex?
Oh my god, all the time.
I don't think it's really applicable
it doesn't
for us,
it doesn't like, it doesn't affect me, it just, I think I just feel more sorry, like more sad for like society that's not still like a normal thing for some people.
Yeah.
Like I've always just been such good friends with guys. Like so many of my close friends are guys.
Yeah, that's true.
But.
Yeah, I think it's kind of odd that sometimes, I mean like today, some people were commenting to us in our eye. Some people were commenting on the Instagram post of me and you on your account asking where Alfie was and why he wasn't there and why we were hanging out. And you're like, well, firstly, Alfie was there. He was the one that took the photo.
Yeah, if you zoom into your sunglasses, you can actually see
it. And it's just kind of, and I get there's a curiosity aspect of it, but I mean, I don't know. I think it also probably helps that I'm gay.
I know, I just don't think people understand that you can be gay or
I guess
be
that kind
a
of
guy
ruins
and
it
not be attracted to
me. That's
more
normal for you to be friends with gay guys rather than heterosexual. It would be easier to address if I was heterosexual because you'd be like, it's fine, we've never been attracted to each other. And some of the questions have been like, have you ever fancied each other? Obviously we can safely,
because,
I can safely say
yeah,
that.
Yeah, no, I've never, I'm sorry Jay, but I have never fancied you.
I think it's just the mentality, and I think it might be an age thing, and this is not, I don't want this to be patronising, because I always used to get frustrated with people being like, oh, you're young, it's fine,
yeah.
That's why you're doing something. But I think it's the kind of like, when you're really young, you're like, ew, boys.
Yeah.
And or ew, girls. So I
or
think
like,
it's kind of a carried
a
on.
With him? Where's Alfie? Like, that's quite, that must be a young, like, mentality.
Yeah, I think so, yeah. I think there's a lot of...
Also, it just worries me that these people have less trust in our, in mine and Alfie's relationship than like...
I just think it's also just really funny, obviously, because I'm gay. And they're like, oh my god, she's cheating on him. And I'm like, no, no.
Oh no, there's so many bees in here, Jay.
Do you know what we should do? I used to see my grandmother do this, is get the vacuum cleaner and you just suck them all up. It works really well.
Oh my god, but they're bees. Or we can suck them up the vacuum and then let them out.
Well, if you really wanted to, but or you could just leave them there.
You are savage.
Well, I know, but what are you going to do? Just shake your Dyson container in the garden?
We have to save the bees. They're like worker bees. They're pissed off worker bees.
What's the thing you miss about the old days?
I just miss...
I think it's not necessarily about the old days of our friendship, because I don't think much has changed, but the kind of the simplicity of being young, and this sounds like such an old man thing to
we
say.
We had like nothing
to
really
worry about.
Worry about.
I know. Like, yeah, and I don't want to be kind of like, make sure you make the most of it, because all I wanted to do when I was young was grow up.
Me too.
All I wanted was independence and my own place. And
all I wanted was to be a mum and be and have a family, and that's and everything else I didn't... I was just like, whatever, everything else kind of comes along with it. Don't wish your time, don't wish your life away.
I still do that though.
You still wish your life away?
On a smaller scale of like, my next trip is booked in X amount of weeks, I want to go now.
But that's like because you're excited.
True, yeah.
Like I kind of do that with Christmas. Like Christmas
you
happens
and, Christmas.
And then it's January and I'm like, screw this year. I just want it to be Christmas again.
Screw you guys. Where do you see your guys' friendship in 10 years time? It's like a job interview.
Oh my god, it will be this, but we'll have kids.
We said actually the other day, I was excited about at the thought of being able to raise our children together.
Yeah.
Like, not together, I mean like,
not together,
our
but
children
like,
hang out.
Yeah, oh my god, how nice would that be? And then they're working New Look together.
Jay, what's your favourite food that Zoe's ever cooked for you? I don't think she's actually ever cooked for me.
Look, one day you can come round and I will have cooked...
A feast.
A feast.
Did you have?
We finished filming our Q&A, which is like the longest Q&A ever. I'm gonna take so long trying to edit that down. We just basically sat and chatted. And then we just looked through all our old Facebook chats and old text messages, which was very entertaining. Oh, sorry, Nala. Now I think we're gonna have, should we have a little ice cream and sit outside?
Yeah.
Oh, we've also got birthday cake flavored fabs. Have you tried one of those?
Birthday cake flavored.
There's a giant white Magnum.
Yes, that's Jay's.
That's Jay's. Jay was like, do you have a white Magnum? I was like, that's very specific. I don't know. But we do.
Cheers, my dears.
Hello. So Jay is cooking up a storm. You are.
Very nice.
And I'm your sous chef. It's a, what is it? Lebanese
spinach
pie.
Pastry. Pie.
I'm currently doing layers of phyllo pastry and butter.
Did you wash your hands?
I did actually, didn't I?
Mm-hmm. I can prepare the pie. How many layers?
Alfie's thinking, if you want me to eat this, you need to verify that you washed
no.
your hands.
Around this time in the evening, Nala likes to sit on this step and she just watches the world. It is so cute. Oh, did you hear me? This is what it's looking like right now. And I finished my 6 layers. It's done! Look how good this looks! Well done.
Thanks.
Give me some. This was mostly you, so. I layered some pastry and wow, Alfie strained some spinach. Okay, I feel like you need to do the first slice.
Oh, there's so much pressure.
I know.
The first piece is always going to be the hardest. I might.
The first cut is the hardest.
It might be.
Makes so much more sense to cut it before, doesn't it?
You might be cutting it now.
Yeah.
Right.
It sounds like it's like. Can you hear it?
It's boiling. Oh my gosh.
Wow, it looks amazing. And then we've got some quinoa and some mash, which was, mine and Alfie's like.
Our input, which is the pre-made in the packet.
To be fair, it's all about the pie.
Holy crap, that looks so good.
Wow. Mmm, thank you so much, Jay.
That's right.